Hello friends, welcome to the series of our engineering lectures. This is the fifth lecture which I am conducting for you people only, which is on helix upon or on cylinder as well as helix on or upon cone. So what is helix? Helix is nothing but it is a curve generated by a point moving along the surface of a right circular cylinder, and at the same time it advances in the axial direction of this cylinder at a speed which bears a constant ratio to the speed of rotation. This particular helix curve, it may be upon cylinder, it may be upon cone, it is having the applications in manufacturing of the helical springs and manufacturing of the helical gears, as well as in various applications as far as engineering areas are considered one. So this is all about the applications. Right now we will go for solving a simple numerical on this topic. The statement is, draw a helix of one convolution upon a cylinder given 80 millimeter page and 50 millimeter diameter of the cylinder. Now here the statement can be stated in another way, that draw a helix for a cylinder having 50 millimeter diameter and 80 millimeter height. That means whatever the height of the cylinder is there, that becomes pitch here. That is the only change. Okay. But in another case, if the height of the cylinder is, its diameter is 50, height is 80, but they are saying that pitch is 60. So you need to draw the helix for only up to 60 millimeter and not up to 80 millimeter. So pitch is very, very important. But what is it? It is nothing but the axial advancement of this point, axial advancement of this P point along the surface of the cylinder in axial direction, so that it will come again to that particular point, but at some distance, means to that particular plane you can see, but at some distance, so that it will travel some distance, which is nothing but the pitch. So try to remember this one. This is important parameter as far as to draw helix with the help of graphical method is considered. Now we will see the simple solution of this particular problem in graphical way. As the diameter of the cylinder is 50 millimeter and 80 millimeter is the pitch, which is equal to the height of the cylinder, we will go for, first of all, first step is construct the orthographic view of cylinder. That means what? Whenever you want to observe this cylinder from top view, always start from top view, draw a circle of given diameter. Dimension this circle as per our rules and regulations, that how to dimension it, make here two arrows, then try to have a leader line here, then write down here 550. After drawing this circle as a plan of this cylinder, divide this circle into 8 equal parts, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now here it has been assumed that this point is moving in this manner. Whenever we are going to see that it will be moving along the surface of the cylinder in anti-clockwise manner. Try to remember this one. Okay, here that direction should be shown like this arrow. It should be like this, and this arrow should be there here, so that it will move in anti-clockwise manner. So try to remember this one. That is very, very important one. Now what we will see here, after drawing this one, here is your XY line actually, below which you are going to draw this circle for top view of the cylinder. Project these lines in upward direction. Project all the lines from P, this line, from 6, this one, from 7, from 5, from 4, and construct and mark along this axis here at a distance of 80 millimeter height, so that you can construct this cylinder which will be observed as a rectangle in elevation or in front view. Project 1 and 7 are in line with each other. These are the imaginary generators. This is the generator. This 2 and 6, these are the imaginary generators. So this is the this is observed in elevation like this one. 3 and 5, this is the imaginary generator. This is actually the generator which will be visualized to the observer. So therefore it has been made darker. This is the top edge, which will be circular one from the top, but which will be straighter one from the front. The same thing is applicable to the bottom part. Now after drawing this two, that is elevation, front view and top view of this diameter of the cylinder. Try to give the dimension here. Vertical line at a distance of 8 to 10 millimeters from the object line of 80 millimeter. If you draw this much of thing only, you will get at least, as this will be asked for 10 marks. This will be asked for 10 marks. Now, it has not been sure that whether they will be asking you only one problem or two problems. So, but if at all they'll be asking you for 10 marks, then definitely you will get 3 to 4 marks for drawing this much of thing only. Yeah, provided that all the things are done in proper manner and in correct manner. Now, after this one, we will proceed further for drawing the this particular curve, which is shown here in this way. Now, after this one, whatever the height, you need to go for dividing that particular part of this height, which is equal to pitch. Now, here, pitch is already given and that we have taken it as the height. So here we will divide this 80 millimeter into 8 equal parts. Now it is easier one to divide 80 millimeter into 8 equal parts, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10. But if it's suppose 75 millimeter, then it will be very difficult one for you. So then you have to go for what? For drawing for or using that particular kind of method, that is dividing a line into equal number of parts by graphical nature or by graphical method, that you can use it here. But indeed now here as it is 80 millimeter, it is not necessary. You can go 10, 10, 10, 10, 10 like this one, so that it will be 8 number of parts. Now, whatever the 8 divisions, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Through this one, you can draw 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. These parallel lines to this particular base of this cylinder. Or you can say this diameter P4. One and the same thing. For this P, we are going to draw the curve. Try to remember this one. Now here, these horizontal lines, whatever you have drawn through 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 divisions, I need 8th one already available one, it will be intersecting with the generators passing through 1 and 7, passing through 6 and 2, passing through 5 and 3, passing through 4. Now wherever these particular generators are cutting these horizontal projection lines, whatever you have drawn, you are getting certain points. That points are generally the points which will lie on your helical curve on cylinder. So this is the first point. See, this is the first horizontal line and this is the generator for, this is the generator. You have to name it here actually. It has not been named here as far as this particular figure is considered one, which is somewhat we can say incomplete actually, but I just wanted to tell you the procedure. So here this is suppose 8 point. So here it is 8 dash. 8 dash will be here. Here it is 1 dash on this side because on the front side, 7 dash will be at the back. 2 dash will be on the front side. 6 dash will be at the back. 3 dash will be on the front side. 5 dash will be at the back, and 4 dash will be here. I hope this is very clear to you. The same points naming you can give it here because the generators are, this is 8, 8, this is 1, 1 from the front, 7, 7 at the back, then this is 2, 2 at the front, 6, 6 at the back, 3, 3 at the front, 5, 5 at the back, and 4, 4. Here it is only one generator, but here these generators are in front of each other. Therefore, the naming will be like this one. Now here, as wide, it is touching, see the projector is from 1, here it is going like this one, 1 and 7, 1 and the same thing. Horizontal line through 1, projector through 1, this is P1. Now you may be having certain doubt in your mind, where is 7? 7 is at the back and it will come here. Try to remember this one. Why? Because it is at the back, it is at the back, it is not at the front side. Because the point is moving like this way. Okay, then 2 to 6. Here 2, here 6, 2. Then here we will only consider 2 right now. Here this is projector from 3, horizontal line from 3, intersecting point 3. Projector from 4, horizontal line from 4, P4. Projector from 5, horizontal line from 5, P5. Projector from 6, horizontal line from 6, P6. Projector from 7, horizontal line from 7, P7. And projector from 8. Horizontal line already from 8, and that is P is already starting there. Again P is starting, again it will take like this particular curvature and it will again move away. If it will be of the two convolutions, it will be in the next stage. If it go after beyond the another, I mean next pitch. Try to remember this. The pitch will remain same, but it will be of the second convolution. So So try to remember this one in this way. Now here one very important thing, from P to P4 it has been shown as the continuous one, and from P4 to P8 it has been shown as dotted. Why? Already I have told you this is the movement, anti-clockwise movement of the P. So whenever it is B at location 1, 2, 3, 4, as far as these generators are considered, when it will be visible because observer is from this particular side. So therefore it is continuous, and whenever it will go to 5, 6, 7 and again to 8, it will be not visible to the observer, and therefore it has been shown by the dotted line. So it's very simple. So I hope this particular method is ready now, very well explained by me. Try to understand it properly, practice it, and if at all any problem is there, you can text me on WhatsApp. I'll be always ready for helping you regarding your various queries as well as your doubts. Next we will see about the helix on cone or helix upon a cone. Now here method is very simple, method is similar one, but one very important thing here, whenever the helix upon cylinder can be drawn, we cannot have any kind of curved nature here in the top view, because it is along the circumference of this right circular cylinder and it will be definitely a circle itself. So therefore there is nothing will be observed in top view as far as helix upon cylinder is considered one. But if you go for helix on cone, it will be what? You are going to observe something here. Now what is helix on cone? It is nothing but a curve traced out by a point which moves around the surface of a right circular cone, and at the same time which moves around the surface of the right circular cone, and at the same time it advances in the axial direction of it, so that at a speed which bears the constant ratio to the speed of rotation. Means this speed and the rotation speed, they are having a constant ratio, then and then we will get a proper curve. Now this also can be explained with the help of an example. Draw a helix of one convolution upon a cone which is having the diameter of base 70 mm, axis 90 mm and 90 mm pitch. Now here axis length is 90, pitch is 90, so pitch is equal to the height of this particular cone. Now here the axial, this is again the same thing, the axial advancement of that point during one complete revolution is known as pitch of the helix. Now, already I have explained you this thing in case of helix upon a cylinder, so I think no need to explain it again here. Now how to go for drawing this one? Very simple procedure again. Here you need to go for drawing an orthographic view of a cone, and that already we have drawn so many times in our earlier classroom sessions as well as practical sessions. Now here again here for a cone you need to go for drawing its top view, which is nothing but a circle having the diameter equal to 70 millimeter. Try to name it properly, that is starting from here 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8. Try to dimension it properly as per our rules and regulations. Then second thing is that whatever the points which are available here, this should be with very very faint nature divisions. Now try to have the XY line, project all the points, project the axis line here, along the axis line try to mark 90 millimeter, which is the axis height, is the height of the cone. Now from this point draw this one, that is suppose this is X point, so X to this particular P, or you can say it is 8 point again, and here X to this 4. Here also the naming is 1 to 8, so this is 8 dash, always we are representing here dashes, that is the front view points, and non-dashes will be the plan or top view points. This is 1 dash, this is 8 dash, this is 1 dash here, 7 dash on that other side, that is back side. Here 3 dash, 6 dash at the back side. Here it is 2 dash, 6 dash at the back side. Here it is 3 dash, 5 dash at the back side, and here it is 4 dash. And try to connect this one, that is X, suppose this is X and Y, so here it is XY, that is the axis point, X dash here, Y dash here. Join X to 1 as well as X to 7, that is slant generator of the cone. This is X2, this is already axis line is available one for X6 and X2. This is X5 as well as X3, and this is x4, which is already we have drawn. As this is made darker because this is the visible outline of the this particular cone. Now here, one again another very important thing, that now here we have completed the top view of cone as well as front view of cone. I think this is very clear. Again, here you will get 3 to 4 marks if it is for the 10 marks. Okay. Now, after this, what you need to do? A very important thing, that here in case of cylinder, we have divided this axis side, which is vertical one, into 8 equal parts. Why? Because we have divided circle into 8 equal parts. If it is divided into 12 equal parts, we need to divide this into 12 equal parts. It depends solely on you. This decision is yours. Okay. Now here we have divided this into 8 equal parts. So here we will divide this height, that is slant height, this slant generator x to 8, or this is the point which is moving actually, but here it should be 8 dash point. So this is x to 8 generator. We are going to divide this again into how many number of equal parts? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Now this is very difficult one, I did know, because it is somewhat greater than 90. It is very difficult one to get whatever the number of divisions which are coming here, like 11 point something or like that one. So better way, go for drawing a line at less than 45 degree angle. Divide that into 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and draw a parallel line, or draw a line which is joining end point of this line to this point, and draw the parallel lines through whatever the available points here, so that you will get the required number of equal divisions here for this one with the help of a graphical method. After getting this points here with the help of graphical method is the only option available here with you. Don't go for any another option. Draw horizontal lines through this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, that is all divisible 8 points are available, one through which draw the horizontal lines parallel to the base of the cone. Okay, why? To get the points on the curve. Now here we will go for horizontal line like this one, and one very important thing is that whatever the divisions which are available one in the plan, from this one, this is the projector for 8 dash, from this one, this is the projector for what, 1 and 7, this is the projector for 6 and 2, this is for 5 and 3, and this is for 4. Join this one to this. This is the, already I have told you, this is projector, that is this is generator, imaginary generator, x1 as well as x7, this is x2 as well as x6, this is x3 as well as x5, and this is x4. So these horizontal lines will be meeting to these slant generators at this junction. Here this is p1 point, second will be meeting at this junction, this will be p2 point, third will be meeting at this junction, that is, see, p1, the project, the parallel line through 1 and x1 generator, p1 point, parallel line through 2, projector through, that is x2 projector. Why x2? Because earlier when it, the second will be visible one first, first will be visible one first, then third one, parallel line through 3, and this will be x3, parallel line through 4, this will be x4, which are giving us p1, p2, p3 and p4. As the point is moving in anti-clockwise direction, 1, 2, 3, 4 are visible one, therefore this curve will be continuous. From after p4, p5 is again this one, which is at the back side of this one. So 5 x5, p5, 6 x6, p6, 7 x7, p7, and again it will be p, that is up to here, apex. Is this clear? So in this case, as from p4 to this p7 and after this up to apex, it is 5 6 7, which is at the back, because from this side we are observing, this is at the back, which is not visible to us, therefore it will be shown by a smooth line, first of all with the free hand, and then afterwards it will be drawn with the help of French curve, so that will be dotted line. In this case also, it will be first of all drawn with the free hand, and then it will be make it a fair with the help of French curve. I don't remember this one. So in this way it can be prepared one. Now this is the helical nature of the curve, which can be observed on a cone which is in the front view. But as it is a cone, the things will be observed in plan also, because it is having somewhat such a type of shape. In case of cylinder, it is having a cylindrical nature. These two lines are parallel, therefore this curve will look like a cylinder, a circle only, and therefore we have not shown anything in plan here. But it is not the case in case of helix on the cone, helix upon the cone. So here we need to show all these points in plan of the cone also. So how to show it? Very simple thing. P has been here, so P should be here at this particular point in plan. After this, where should the P is moving, like this one. So first of all, it will come on what? This first generator. So here is the first generator, X1. So this is the point. This point directly can be projected on the P1 is on what? X and 1 dash. X dash and 1 dash. So it will be projected. See my this particular red cursor. It will be projected. P will be projected. P1 will be projected here. It will be P1. P2. Now P2 cannot be projected here. Where it should be projected, it is very difficult one. So what we will do, we will, because this is not the actual line, so here it will be projected on slant line, true slant line, that is up to 2 here. Then it will be again projected here on this, where we have projected it on XP. So here it will be projected on what? XP. And then it will be rotated so that we will get the P2. In the similar manner, P3 will be here. It will be projected. It will be projected on P3 is where? On X dash 3 dash. So it will be projected on X dash here on X3. P4 will be on what? X4. So P4 can be directly projected here. P4 will be directly projected on here. P4. P5 will be on what? X5. So P5 will be directly projected on this X5. P6, again it will be on the center line. It is very difficult one to project it. So P6 we will project it on this X6 here, XP. So again from 6 we will go on it for what? This XP, and from this one it will be rotated so that we will get P6. P7 will be on what? X7. So again it will be coming here and it will be here P7. P8 is apex only, so it will be here coming here. So join these points with the help of a smooth curve, with the help of a freehand, so that we'll get the smooth curve and make it fair with the help of French curve, so that it will be observed as such a kind of curve, which is nothing but a spiral actually. Whatever the next curve we are going to learn, it is nothing but like this one, which is a one convolution spiral. That is the whenever we're going to observe it from the plan. So this is in this way. This problem can be solved. Try to only remember about the pitch. If it is equal to the axis of the height, axis height, then go for full length, full height as far as drawing of this helical nature is considered one. If it is not equal to the axis height, if pitch is less than the axis height, suppose it is up to here only, up to 80 millimeter. So the curve will end here itself and not, it will not go up to the apex. So I hope this is very clear to you as far as helix on cone as well as helix on cylinder, or helix upon cone as well as helix upon cylinder is considered one. These are somewhat the references which generally I'm using, and many of the students as well as many of the faculty members are using, like engineering drawing by Andy Vert, engineering graphics by K. Venugopala and his counterpart Zoli D.A., engineering drawing with introduction to AutoCAD, as well as these are some of the PPTs I'm using for getting some features, so that it will be very well understandable for all of you. So thank you very much to all these particular people. Thank you very much. Here I'm ending with my this particular engineering curves, helix on cone as well as helix on cylinder lecture. Thank you very much.